Looks pretty ugly, doesn't it? This is Mr. Bass, and this is one nasty backlash. 30-pound braid, and this is the worst kind of a backlash. This kind usually doesn't happen by throwing in the wind or something like that. The way this happens is you rear back, ready to launch your lure. And I had a frog on and I was trying to launch it really, really far. I had the new launch frog on and I was attempting to really chuck this thing. So I really reared back to really heave it. And when I went back behind my head, my lure looped around a tree limb just at the right time. And that kind of combination is what creates this insanely deadly backlash. So what can be done about this? Is it possible to save this or salvage this? If it were fluorocarbon or mono, I would say the chances are much greater to save it, to tell you the truth, because there are a lot of tricks you can try, like the thumb trick, where you put a bunch of pressure on the thumb and reel the spool in, then hit the button, then pull out the line, then hold with pressure on the thumb, reel the spool in. You do that repeatedly over and over and over. And most of the time you can get that out with fluorocarbon. But braid is a different animal, especially when what happened is I have this massive section of loops that have completely separated from the main spool, and they've separated by about this much, 2 inches or more. And the thumb trick does not work. In fact, there's a lot of other things you could try, but practically nothing works. There's three options here. Tear it all out, cut it all out, and throw it away. That's option number one, and that's normally what I do. Problem is, line is getting so expensive. This is a really expensive braid. So what else? I was able to wind most of it back up. And I had this spool completely full. So I could cut this stuff out. And the reality is there'd still be a lot of line on here and I could use it. But I would like to save all this too, because the good thing about braid is even these kinks and tight knots and stuff in here don't really damage the line in a way that you can reuse it. So the only way to do this is you got to have a lot of time on your hands. And what you've got to do is literally you take your main line right here. There's the main line. You give a little snug pull when you know for a fact nothing's giving. You've literally got to dig in here and find it in this knot and start pulling the line out. And this takes a lot of patience because, quite frankly, this can take a long time. But what you do is you dig and you dig and you dig and until you find your line. And you literally pull that line, every bit of it, all however many feet that you've got free now, out of the knot. Then you give it another tug, see if it will move. If not, you go back, you find the line again, and you pull it all the way out of the knot again. And you do repeat this process over and over. You find it, pull the entire line out of the knot, repeat. Find it, pull the entire line out of the knot, repeat. And you do that over and over and over until this thing finally gives way. So let me go through that process and then I'll show you that you can actually save this.
When you got what you want, baby. Okay, so I've been working on this for about 30 minutes, and I'm making progress, even though it probably doesn't look like it. One thing that you can do, you've got to follow the line, and you've got to keep your eye on where this line's at and work it out. It's nice if you can push the line up like this. I don't know if you can see that, but here's my line. And if you can push it, and that'll help you get your way out. But another thing, another tool that will help work good, you need something pointed, but you need something pointed that's not going to cut your line or tangle your line. So I like to use toothpicks. And this is a plastic toothpick, but a wooden toothpick works. And that'll help you kind of flip through some of this and locate the line that you need so that you can continue to dig it out. Obviously, this doesn't work when you're on the water, especially if you're in a tournament situation, which is why you need backups. But even if you're fun fishing, if you're crazy enough to want to get all this out, you need time, and time is not your friend on the water. It burns away very quickly. So when I get home, maybe I'm watching a ball game or something, I may have a reel like this that I say, I'm going to try to save that line. And then I'll spend time digging it out. But it takes incredible patience to not just say, ah, screw it, I'm cutting this line and going on down the road. The other thing you got to be careful of is this method of unwinding all your line like this creates a pile of line on the floor that you could also get tangled and ruin anyway. And so you got to get all this line that you peel off, you've got to get reeled back up on your reel. And sometimes that's harder than it sounds, because you'll get it all tangled in a ball on the floor at your feet. So when you're untangling, see, just like that, when you're untangling line, you need to be really careful not to create a new knot like this. See, that's possibly a new knot that could turn into a bunch of knots. You gotta make sure you don't let that happen as you're working on this line. So with that being said, let's see if we can speed this up again and get on through this. Okay, this is day two, and I'm almost 3 hours into this. I went about 2 hours, a little more than 2 hours last night, and then just had to have a break. Then I got on this, and maybe I've been doing it half an hour, so it's probably more like 2.5 hours. And the funny thing about this is you just work it, get your toothpick, and you work it, and you work it, and you work it, and you work it, and it just feels like forever. It's never going to get resolved. And then it just starts doing this. It just starts giving way a little at a time, a little at a time, and it gets easier and easier to pull. And more of this crap start to dissipate. And eventually, just like a Mike Long big fish story, it just all starts unraveling and this whole big knot comes completely unwound and you eventually get it completely out, completely done. So that in and of itself is kind of rewarding, but the reality is it worth it to spend 3 solid hours trying to get a backlash out? No, in my opinion, it's absolutely not worth it. The only reason I'm sticking with this is just for this video, just to demonstrate to you, yes, it absolutely can be done. If you're patient, you got a lot of time on your hands, you can make it happen. You can get it done. You can get it completely unwound and go from there. So I'd say maybe 10 more minutes, 15, worst case another half hour, I'll be done with this. So looking forward to that for sure, and then I'll show you what the finished product looks like. Alright, here it is. Look at that. It's given up the ghost. It has finally lost the battle. Look, one last little deal trying to hold on. Nope. I have defeated it. There it is. Completely cleared. It's pretty darn exciting that after all that work, really over 3 hours, I have conquered. There it is, done deal, completely fixed. So you can absolutely fix backlashes. It's painful, depending upon how bad they are. Most of them never take this long. Tell you the truth, this sucker would have gone in the trash after about 10 minutes of trying to crack that nut. But I was like, nope, I'm making this video and I'm gonna stick with it through the whole thing, and we're gonna make this thing work and come up with show you that no matter how bad and ugly they are, if you've got enough patience and time, you can fix them. So hopefully that doesn't happen to you very often. And if it does, just remember, if you got the time, you can make it happen. Thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate it. Like, subscribe, and share if you feel so inclined. Until next time, this is Mr. Bass. Happy fishing.